in the description box, I have given the link for other videos and practical experiments. Please subscribe my channel for new updates.
Hello students. Today I am going to explain half adder and half subtractor using IC7400, means using NAND gates alone. You're seeing this circuit. If I don't use gate, this circuit is just like realization of XOR gate. This realization of XOR gate already I have done in 7400 as universal gate experiment. You can watch that video. And also you are aware that 7400 IC is a quad 2 input IC, means it has only 4 gates. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. There are 5 gates. But 7400 IC is having 4 gates, but half adder need 5 gates. So it is very simple that I need to use 2 ICs. I cannot use gate 1 as gate 5. Remember, we need to use 2 ICs. Similarly, from this circuit, there is a small change for half subtractor.
For half adder, carry was taken from pin number 3 to the next gate, whereas for half subtractor, from pin number 8, we are taking it for borrow. So that is the only change. Instead of from pin number 3, we need to connect it from pin number 8. Half adder truth table, if inputs are 0 and 0, sum is 0, carry is 0. If inputs are 0, 1 or 1, 0, sum is 1, carry is 0. If inputs are 1 and 1, sum is 0, carry is 1. This is shown in the voltage table also.
We need to measure sum as well as carry and write. When it comes to half subtractor,
truth table, A is 0, B is 0, difference is 0, borrow is 0. If 1, 0, difference is 1, borrow is 0. 1, 1, both difference and borrow are 0. Whereas if I subtract 0 minus 1 from lower number to higher number, I need to take a borrow. Since it is a binary number, the borrow will be 2. 2 minus 1, the difference is 1. But I have taken a borrow to subtract, so I have to write borrow also 1.
Same thing I am using here, the voltage table. So let me verify this after construction. See, there is a notch, you can see. This notch, you need to insert it on top. So I will insert it like this, hold it and latch it. Since I need 2 ICs, I do the same thing. Open this lock and insert the second IC here. Also, remember, whenever we connect ICs, we need to connect their biasing inputs. That is pin number 14. I told this already. Since this is a 16 pin socket, whereas IC is 14 pin, 1 to 7, this will be pin number 8. These two, we are not having any connection. You could see it is written in pen also. So this becomes 14, not 16. 14 to plus 5 volt. Then pin number 7 to ground. Similarly, I need to connect for the second IC. That is, this is the ground for second IC and 14 to plus 5 volt. These two are fixed. You should not change this throughout the experiment. Now let us connect the circuit. I tell the pin numbers and connect. You can see the circuit. I'll just explain here. You can see the circuit. Pin number 1 to A, that is one input. Pin number 1 to 4. Pin number 2 to B, again from pin number 2 to 10. 3 to 5, 5 to 9. Pin number 3 to pin number 1 and 2 shorted for the second IC. This we will do later. All this are over. 6 to 12, 8 to 30, then 11 to output. Once we finish this, we will verify for XOR gate. If it is coming, then we will move on to this gate. Pin number 1 to input I gave, same pin number 1 to 4 I connected. The second thing is pin number 2. Pin number 2 to another input, then same pin number 2 I need to connect it to pin number 10. 8, 9, 10. So 1 and 2 is over, I'll come to 3. Pin number 3 to 5, from 5 to 9. So this part is over. This is 9. Then I should move on to pin number 6. Pin number 6 to 12. This is 12, not 14, 12 it is. Then pin number 8 to 13. This is 13. Then what is left out? You could observe only pin number 11. Pin number 11 should be connected to output. This is actually the sum output. I'll switch on now and I'll verify the truth table. 00, it is 0. 01, it is 1. 10, 1110. Means the XOR gate is verified. So that I can move on to the next part of the circuit. Next part of the circuit is pin number 3 of the first IC. Remember, pin number 3 of the first IC, I need to connect it to pin number 1 of the second IC. And pin number 1 and 2 of the second IC, I need to short it. Then pin number 3, I need to take and connect it as carry. Since carry has a higher value, I connect carry here. This is sum, this is carry. I can even shift it here so that you can see this properly. Now the connection is over. Let us verify the truth table. How to do that? I need to connect the multimeter. Now for connecting the multimeter, let me connect it to ground. Any one of the pin number 7 I can connect the negative. Whereas the positive, I need to hold it at that junction to measure the output. Let me first verify whether it is working or not. 00. Output is 0. 01, you could notice this is sum. Sum is high, carry is 0. 10, again sum is high, carry is 0. When I make 11, you're noticing sum becomes 0, carry becomes 1. Because 11, it is binary 2, could be written as 10. Now what I should do is for 00, I need to measure sum and carry. What I can do is, you can see in the last video also I have told, you can insert it like this. You can just measure the reading. So we will see the reading. Since it is 0, you are getting 0.15. This is for sum. Then same way you measure for carry. You are getting the same thing. Now I will make 01 as the input. So that sum is high, carry is low. You are noticing I have already kept it at carry. So I am measuring first carry, 0.09. Then I will measure sum. Notice it is above 3 or 3.2 or 3. This is for sum. Then what I do is 10 I am doing. Instead of 01, I am doing 10. Now also the same thing. Then I take 11, you notice sum becomes 0 and the value is 0.15. Now I have to measure the carry. Carry I got it as 3.45. That's all. The truth table of half adder is verified. Let us now move on to half subtractor. Before I do the connections, I'll just explain this once again. For the second IC, I connected from pin number 3. Now, the circuit almost looking similar. Instead of pin number 3, I am connecting it from pin number 8. That's all. So what I do is, I'll not disconnect the complete circuit. One thing you remember, this is the wire. Just find out what is the wire which is going to the second IC pin number 1. Not the shorted wire. This is the shorted wire. The other wire like this, just check this and find this is the wire. Switch off this, remove this, check which is pin number 8. This is pin number 8. Bring it back, connect it to pin number 8. That's all. Now you can cross verify. I'll not measure the output for all the cases. I'll just show you the truth table. 0, 0. Difference is 0. Borrow is 0. 0, 1. You could notice difference is also 1. Borrow is also 1. Because as I said, 0 minus 1, you are subtracting higher number from lower number. So that the borrow I need to take to subtract. I have taken 1 borrow. The difference is 1. Then when I make it,
if the input is 1, 0.
Difference is 1. I have not taken any borrow because it is 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0 is 1. I am not taking any borrow. When I make 1, 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. So let me take this combination 0 minus 1 to measure and show you. You can notice both are high. So I am measuring borrow now. Borrow is also giving 3.44. Now I will measure the difference. Difference is also giving 3.38. Like this you can measure at different combinations of inputs at the output. So the truth table of half adder as well as half subtractor is verified. One thing only you need to remember is we need two ICs, not one IC. Gate number 1 for this IC is totally having different function than this IC. That if you remember, your connection will go on. Again, second point to remember is 7 to 0, 14 to plus VCC or 5 volt is a must for both the ICs. If you do this, and again the number of wires, as I said in the previous experiment, the number of wires should be what is being written. For example, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. For this we need 12 wires plus 2 for biasing. We are not connecting any additional wires. So even for half subtractor, it is 14 wires only. Thank you.